Hey everybody, I want to start this by showing me soaking the beans first, okay? I have a bag of pinto beans to your left. I have a tablespoon of baking soda, and I have a bowl with a colander in it and cold water, okay? See this? Cold water. I'm going to pour the bag of pinto beans in the water. I'm going to let them soak overnight. And then tomorrow, we're going to cook these beans in a crock pot with turkey necks, which is very health conscious and diabetic friendly as well. So, with all that said, I'm just going to pour them in there. Here, I can do this now. I can sprinkle the baking soda. Now, let me tell you about the baking soda. They say that the baking soda helps reduce gas. Okay, in you. Like if you put baking soda in your beans and soak them, then it won't cause people to have as much gas. Okay, so I have the baking soda in there. It's pretty much dissolved. The beans, we're going to wash off tomorrow anyway. It's not a big deal. Our main thing is to soak them. So what I do is just take the bag, open it up, and pour the beans in the bag. Okay, and that's it. I let them sit till tomorrow. And then I'll show you what I do, how I rinse them off. I do pick through them and see if there's anything in there. See, there's something in there now. It looks like a piece of dirt. Of course, we want to throw that out. But like I said, we're going to rinse them tomorrow. Our main thing is to let them soak in the baking soda. I'll Google up other reasons why people use baking soda, but I always thought it was for flatulence, which is a nice way of saying gas, reducing gas in people. So I'll let you know tomorrow for sure, okay? But right now we're going to let them soak. And tomorrow I'll show you them before I get started. And we'll see how they look, okay? Have a good night. Hi, everybody. I'm back again. Today we're going to do Aunt Minnie's pinto beans in the crock pot. Very simple. Just want to teach you basics about beans. You know we're all about how to cook. So we want to start from the beginning like you've never done it before. Oh, I want to tell you Happy New Year. This is 2012. How cool is that? So we're going to start with pinto beans. We're going to start first with, you know, we soaked the beans. And I have a short video before this where I had soaked the beans overnight. And this is how they look. It's a funny thing my dad mentioned that to make sure that you clean these beans because all the machines do is grab them and shake most of the dirt off and rinse them real quick. So you make sure you rinse your beans good. Now, I told him, and as you will see in the video, I did not rinse them when I put them into the water. I simply poured the bag into the water, but I'm going to sort them today and I'm going to show you how, okay? If you can see this, but I'm going to try to show you how the water looks. See how dirty and murky that is? Okay, that got most of it off, but we're going to get the rest of it off, okay? So, we did that. You pour a few more in. All you're looking for is a bad bean. Very seldom you'll see it, and you will know it because it'll be a little different from the others. Not necessarily darker from the others, but just different. So you will know it. And ironically, we don't have any in here, and you don't. When your water come out clear, you know you don't, okay? So now we have clean beans, and we're getting ready to start. Like I said, we're going to cook them in the crock pot. Now, I've put 6 cups of water in this crock pot, okay? And it's an oldie, but it's a goodie. It works very well. I put it on high because it's close to the afternoon, so I want to make sure they're done. They soaked overnight, so you see they swelled quite a bit from what they used to look like. So we're going to pour them in here, in the crock pot. Now that's 6 cups of cold water. And that looks to be just about what we need. I have turkey necks. You know how I am about to smoke turkey necks. Keep them whole and just place them in there. I have a tablespoon of seasoning salt. Sprinkle that in. I have a half of tablespoon of garlic. I just like that taste with the beans. And I have a tablespoon of black pepper. And I have a teaspoon and a half of cumin. C-U-M-I-N. I've talked to you about cumin before in my other videos. And once again, it helps the flatulence, which is you having gas. It does assist in that. So if you like, you can give it all a quick stir just to make sure. It's going to cook in there really well. Like I said, it's best if you season things that's hard to penetrate, like beans, first. And then after you taste them, season them a little bit more if necessary. Then you can't lose, okay? So we got it on high. We're going to put a glass top over it. And we're going to set these to the side, and we'll be back once they're done and show you how they look. That's it. If you got a crock pot, you can put it on low, do it before you go to work, put it to the side, make sure all your plugs and everything are safe, and then you'll see it when you get back. And it'll be done. Your dinner will be done. You can fry some chicken wings with it, have cornbread, and you're set to go. So most likely we're going to have cornbread because Aunt Minnie has a cornbread, and I want you guys to see it. So that's it for now. And we're going to let these beans sit, and we'll be back when they're done. This one bag of pinto beans was 89 cents. Now, it's 16 ounces. It'll feed approximately 4 to 5 people for 89 cents. If you add your cornbread and you add, let's say, the cost of the chicken wings all together, you're still going on like $1.25 a meal. You can't beat that. You cannot feed a family of five for $5, $6. I don't care who you are and what restaurant you go to. McDonald's not going to feed your family for $6 and have half the protein that beans have, much less if you couple it with chicken and slice of tomato and have some cornbread. You know you can't beat that. So I wanted you to know that because that's very important because you know we're all about budgeting. So there you go. I'll see you in a little while.